I came up here kind of expecting just to see God move a lot. And I was like, man, God's gonna do something good. And he always comes through. So what I learned, that I have to pursue God, and that it's not about me trying to better myself every day, really. It's about me pursuing Him and trying to be in relationship with Him more than anything.
This weekend, God really put something on my heart. During quiet time, I was like seeing chains when I would close my eyes. He told me that like I was holding on to something that I really shouldn't have been, like grudges and stuff. He helped me let it go. I feel better. I feel more open to things, and it was awesome.
This weekend was a really nice experience. I got to feel really blessed, and I got to hang out with all these people and get closer to them. I got to learn more about God and how He loves us and what He does and what He cares for us. I learned what it truly means to cleanse yourself from sin and live by what God wants you to live by. And it was a really nice weekend, and I'm glad I came.
Before, I was like a super shy person. I did not like talking to people. I was antisocial, and basically I needed to boost my confidence. And when I first came here, boom, all that went away. I started feeling more confident, more into myself, and pretty sooner or later, I wasn't shy anymore. So God really helped me with that.
The other night during ministry time, I was too nervous to like go up to anybody. And so I was praying, and I was like, God, can you please just send somebody up to me? No joke, like a minute later, Kate walks up to me, and she didn't even get like a sign from God to even like come pray for me. She was just checking if I was okay, because I had like gotten hurt from something earlier. And so then I ended up explaining it to her, and she was super surprised, and so she ended up praying for me. And I was crying, and I really felt God in that moment, because I didn't think like anybody really cared. Nobody really knew. And so when she was praying over me, it was like, wow, somebody actually cared. The next day, I'm praying again, and I'm like, can somebody else come up to me and maybe ask me about that certain situation again? Because I was still feeling hurt from that. And Marissa walks up to me, and she tells me that the night before, she actually got a word from God to come up to me, but I had been praying with Kate, and she's like, yeah, so I decided to come up to you tonight. When she was praying for me, I like almost started crying again. I felt so loved in the moment, because both of their prayers, they just had the right words to say.
I've never really felt close with God, I guess. Even though I come to church, I pray, and I do all this stuff, I've never really experienced feeling His presence or anything. And I guess coming here, I was expecting to not feel anything. Like, I was just expecting to come to camp, you know, and experience the same thing that I experience every time I go to youth group, which is just really nothing. But coming here, I felt His presence, and it's so cool. Feeling at peace and feeling His holiness, and, you know, actually fully believing in Him is awesome to me. And I want to feel that for the rest of my life, you know? I think that's really awesome that I've experienced that now coming here.
When Will was talking on the second night of camp, sometimes you feel like God's not there when He's really next to you. That's how I really felt. God wasn't there sometimes. I remember being like, I don't know how to talk to God and follow Him. And so when He said, you could take your time with God, that was pretty, I got kind of emotional, literally had tears. That was pretty cool.
So one thing God taught me during this trip was basically that I have to like stop living in the past. I keep just focusing on these events that like happened in the past, but like by doing that, I'm like running in circles, and basically I'm not gonna get anywhere. And like the main part is that I'm doing it alone. I just kind of leaving out God's. You're trying to earn God's love, even though it's already given to you. So it's like, that's like the main problem for me, because I was trying to do it myself when I really didn't need to do it myself. I had to like rely on others and like on God. That's one of the main things that I learned at camp.
Dylan had prayed for me, and I asked him if he can pray for God to be the king of my life, instead of me being the king of my life. It really touched my heart. It was really nice to have someone pray for me, help me out, instead of me just talking by myself. You know, and then after the prayer, I felt this new energy of me, of a new me, enter my life. I feel a lot happier than I was before. That prayer really touched my heart. You know, I'm not mostly in control of my life no more. It is, I put my life in God's hands, and you know, that made me feel like I was more secure, more sure about my life's choices, because my choices would be a lot better if they're in God's hands. Rather than me making my own decisions, have God help me go on with life. And opening up to God is the best thing you can possibly do, to be honest. You can't get the most out of your life without God.